A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 19th Feb, on the front page you have Pakistan to remain in terror financing watchdog's grey list. So Financial Action Task Force had its meeting in Paris and it has been decided that Pakistan would continue to remain in the grey list of FATF. It has been asked to enact 27-point action plan to curb terror financing. We have been discussing about this. FATF is an international organization which looks into terror financing and money laundering issues, and it reprimands countries for that. So Pakistan has been put in the grey list. There were fears it would go in the black list. Pakistan took last minute steps and it wanted itself to come out of the grey list, but FATF has again decided to continue to put Pakistan, stay in the grey list. Then this is steps shown to deal with virus impact. So Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman met industry leaders and disruption in supply of raw materials from China due to the coronavirus outbreak could have serious impact on several Indian industries, especially the pharma sector. Industry sector leaders have informed the government. So now steps would be taken to deal with the impact. Then below you have curbies against ST status for hill borders. So this is regarding Assam-based insurgent group of curbies. They have also signed a ceasefire agreement with the center, but they're demanding that the Bodos in the hill areas not be given ST status because they say it will affect the identity of the curbies. So Assam government and Bodo groups have also signed an agreement. They have decided on redrawing the boundaries and renaming, that is the Bodoland Territorial Area District as such. So here under that agreement with Bodos, it has been said that Bodos in the hills will be given scheduled hill tribe status. So Kirbis are against this. Bodos in the hill areas not be given the status. And this is Jammu and Kashmir Panchayat by polls put off. So by-elections to over 12,000 vacant panchayat seats in Jammu and Kashmir have been deferred for 3 weeks now following credible inputs from the law enforcement agencies. So CEO cites security reasons and has deferred the exercise by 3 weeks. CEO is Chief Electoral Officer. On page 8 you have UIDAI seeks proof of citizenship. So this is a case from Hyderabad. Here a resident has been asked by UIDAI, Unique Identification Authority of India, to prove his citizenship. And he is going to move High Court once the first hearing concludes. You can see it is said over 1,000 others have also received notices. This is Muhammad Sattar Khan, who has received, a carpenter and auto rickshaw driver, who has received this notice from UIDAI. UIDAI is the apex authority for Aadhaar in the country. So UIDAI in the release has said that Aadhaar has nothing to do with the citizenship. And UIDAI regional office in Hyderabad received reports from the police that 127 people had obtained Aadhaar on false pretenses because they were found to be illegal immigrants. So such Aadhaar numbers are liable to cancellation. Therefore, they've been asked to appear before Aadhaar, UIDAI as such, to prove their citizenship. And here you have documents provided to UK to retrieve stolen idol. So Idol Wing of CID has sought restitution of 16th century bronze. So here you can see this is regarding this idol reportedly which went missing from a temple as such in Tamil Nadu around 50 years ago. So now independent scholar has brought new research to attention relating to the provenance of this Indian 16th century bronze of Saint Tirumangai. So this is Saint Tirumangai as well. So this bronze idol was traced to London Museum. It is in London Museum presently. On page 9 you have Supreme Court voices concern over deforestation. So Supreme Court spoke on deforestation. Chief Justice of India Sharad Bobde said on this bench that deforestation is so rapid that before anyone knows, everything will be lost. So here you can see it was hearing a petition challenging cutting of heritage trees in West Bengal to create space for an overbridge in an accident prone area of a highway. So the significance of forest, significant of tree cover has been spoken of. The green cover must be preserved. It the quote says, when you cut a heritage tree, imagine the value of the oxygen the tree produced all these years. Compare it with how much you would have to pay for the equivalent amount of oxygen if you have to buy it from somewhere else. That is the value of the tree which is spoken of. On the editorial page, the first editorial is visa power. So this we saw in news yesterday, British Labour MP Debbie Abrahams, her visa was provided. E-visa was provided for 1 year, and then suddenly in a few months it has been cancelled. And when she came to India, she was told that her visa is invalid. So she had actually leading a parliamentary group of UK on Kashmir, all party parliamentary group on Kashmir, and she had spoken about it, and she had been critical about the government's action of revoking Article 317 Jammu and Kashmir, and her visa has been revoked. The government says it has been revoked for her anti-India activities. And this is birds hit. So this is the news yesterday which was there, that State of India Birds 2020 scientific report which has been released. It shows how bird diversity in India has been declining and how it must be protected for cultural and ecological reasons. The lead article is in US trade action and Indian counter strategy. So it is said Indian interests would be well served by maintaining a reasonable level of tariff protection. So India-US trade deal is expected, which is not likely in the near future. But the conflict which is there, USA wants India to reduce its tariffs. So what this article talks of is we need to have a reasonable level of tariff protection. What India's counter strategy should be when US takes action against us, if USA has removed us from GSP, generalized system of preferences, it has taken away the developing tag from us and put us in the developed category, so that the benefits which we get in trade with USA are not there. So now what should be India's counter strategy is being spoken of. And this is powering the healthcare engine with innovation. So this is regarding how there is potential for private care providers, innovators and startups to partner in the Ayushman Bharat scheme of the government, which is also called Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. So this is a national health protection scheme. It provides a coverage of up to 5 lakh rupees, for in tier 2, tier 3 cities in hospitalization. So coverage here, the private sector can play an important partner, is what is spoken of in this article. On OPED page, you have the significance of the term secular. So it says the term secular enables focus on religion-based discrimination and misrecognition. So the term secular is, its significance is spoken of. Secularism is considered, say, that it is against discrimination only on the basis of religion. But this article says liberal democracy subsumes secularism, and their secularism is much wider. It is against discrimination of all forms, not just again on basis of religion. Then below you have lending a helping hand. So this is regarding India's tepid response to China's woes. Means when China is suffering from new coronavirus, India has reached out and it has put its impressive soft power gains on notice. So we are ready to help China with masks or any other deficiencies which it is facing. There is a shortage of masks and gloves, so that is being provided. Protective suits being provided. India has promised to provide to China. On page 12, you have NPR can go ahead, says Uddhav. So this is Maharashtra Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray, who says that NPR will be implemented. He says that CN and NRC are different and NPR is different. So no one has to worry. If CA is also implemented, NRC is not there and will not be implemented in the state. So actually, that's what is the stand of BJP also. So, but the thing is that if CA is implemented, Citizenship Amendment Act is implemented to provide citizenship. It is not taking away citizenship from anyone, but it is providing citizenship to illegal immigrants of particular religion from neighboring countries. So if it is providing citizenship to them, it is denying citizenship to Muslims. So if NRC is implemented in future, and if NRC denies citizenship to anyone, non-Muslims, will be able to get citizenship through CA, but Muslims would be illegal migrants. And for Hindus, Sikhs, and other religions, even if they're illegal migrants, they are able to get citizenship through CA. So CA is the problem. NRC would not be a problem if CA is not there. But CA has already been enacted. NRC is not there presently on agenda, but it may come up at any point of time. But then if NRC is implemented, there is no issue. CA should not be there. So that's the whole issue. That is the whole fear. And NPR is related to census, National Population Register. But there also concerns have been raised because NPR forms the basis for NRC. All things are interlinked. Then below you have mediator to talk to protesters and police. So this is senior advocate Sanjay Hegde, which Supreme Court has appointed as interlocutor to hold talks with Shaheenbagh protesters. It has said that they would study the court's order and chalk out a course of action in consultation with all stakeholders. This is there. So government did not appoint any person to speak to the protesters, but now Supreme Court has intervened. Then this is Kothari tipped to be CVC, Julka in CIC. So panel headed by Prime Minister, which goes by majority opinion because opposition leader objected, but others came together and decided on Sanjay Kothari, Secretary to the President of India, to be the next Chief Vigilance Commissioner. And Broadcasting Secretary Vimal Julka will be the Chief Information Officer for RTI. Then on page 13 you have Trump's visit may seal helicopter deal. So this is regarding defense pacts which are likely to be signed during US President Donald Trump's visit to India. So here you can see one of the deal is for multi-role helicopters which will be replacing the Sea King anti-submarine warfare of the country. So this is detailed out here. And this is China thanks India for support during health crisis. So the Chinese envoy says that we look after Indian nationals as our own. So we have provided them with support with respect to equipments also to deal with coronavirus. On international page, you have Ghani named winner of Afghan election. So Ashraf Ghani has secured second term as president of Afghanistan. But his rival Abdullah Abdullah immediately challenged the final election figures and said he was forming his own government. So this is the crisis in Afghanistan too, even after the elections, presidential elections. Then this is World Health Organization urges calm as China virus death toll nears 1,900. And Chinese study of 72,000 patients revealed that 81% of them had only mild infections. Then on business page you have here. Food grain production set to touch a record high. So abundance of late monsoon rains has resulted in larger than expected harvests. So there's a total food grain production in the country for rice, wheat, and even pulses, jawar and bajra, which is higher than average. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you.